If you're a young designer, you work on a project, all you care is to get to the finish line. And then when it's done, you have no idea how you got there or if you can recreate it again.
When you're working with a client, do they care to see the process or do they just want the final result? They don't really care as much how you got there.
Okay. I thought the question was going to be a lot deeper and more interesting. It's a good question. I'm going to answer it, and then I'm going to answer the question that I thought you were going to ask me.
Okay.
Is it good to show process in your portfolio? There are differing schools of thought on this. I personally don't have time to look at your process. I want to see your work. I want to see that it's amazing. And if I really love it, I might ask you about your process.
Okay.
But if you're going to send a link to somebody, I'm not sure that they want to see all that stuff unless it's really well documented and it's designed like it's on purpose, mm-hmm. right? I think a lot of teachers tell students it's all about the process books, and then you sit there with a potential employer and you flip through a 118-page process book of every stupid sketch you've ever drawn. So this is where I think we need to learn to read people and to gauge their interests. Everybody's got one very talkative friend, right?
Yeah.
They could care less if you're listening or not, right? I could look in the corner, I could check my phone, and they just keep talking. Don't be that person with your portfolio.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay? If you want to show process, give it the respect that it deserves, design it, document it really well, build mock-ups around it, and make sure it's telling a very clear story.
Yeah.
Versus like, this is literally everything I've ever done unedited.
Did you think I was going to ask you?
The question that I thought you were asking was, is process important? Process is supremely important.
Oh, I agree.
Okay?
Yeah.
In you knowing how you do what you do. So I posted this thing, I reshared something. It says the difference between amateurs and professionals on Twitter. Amateurs have results and professionals have a process. So what you learn over time is, if you're a young designer, you work on a project, all you care is to get to the finish line. And then when it's done, you have no idea how you got there or if you can recreate it again. And you go through that every single time. And that's where the stress comes from. That's where the creative block comes from. Mm-hmm. The artifacts of what you create is not having a process. I'll give you an example. If you go in the kitchen and you make a pasta sauce, right? And we see that there's basil, there's tomato, there's oregano and herbs and spices and salt and pepper and all these kinds of things. People mistakenly think, well, there's oregano, there's the tomato, there's all these things. That's a process. That's not a process at all. A process is, this is the what you have to do when you go to the supermarket. This is what you need to buy. This is how long the prep time takes. This is how long you have to let certain things simmer for. This is when you incorporate things. This percentage of that with this equals this result time and time again.
So do you think habit and process can overlap in a way?
They're a little bit different.
Yes.
They feel like they're the same, but they're not the same to me. Mm-hmm. Habit is just merely doing something over and over again. Process is understanding and having the wherewithal to know that this is how I got from here to here to here. Mm-hmm. Those are very different things. We all have habits. Not all of us have a process.